Stop it, so do you.
Right, quiet on set. 30 seconds to network trailer. Good luck, everybody. We're going to smash this.
That's right.
Jesus' name.
20 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Hello, hello. Hope you're fine and dandy. Join us in half an hour for Urban Access.
That's right. We've got so much great stuff in store for you.
A live performance from Vintage Soul, street food, and what's new in urban fashion.
Urban fashion. So carry on tweeting, hashtag Urban Access, for the latest updates on the show you create. Keep on tweeting, hashtag Urban Access. What's up, everyone? Welcome to Urban Access, the show that you created.
Following update from last week's tweets and suggestions for this week's show.
Yeah, that's right. That's right, tweeters. You can tweet us at during the show, hashtag Urban Access.
But right now, join us with a live performance from Vintage Soul performing their banging new track, Six.
Six.
Yeah.
That was actually mind-blowing.
That was amazing. What is your name? You know, I was trying to hit the note, but I couldn't. Yeah.
Yeah, leave it to them, right?
I'll leave it to them next time, yeah.
So we have our first tweet here from username at @j_j_Walshe, who says, can we have something about street food? I need to eat on the go, #busylife.
Well, that is a busy life with that sort of name. Well, the answer is yes, of course. And we found the man for the job.
Hi, my name's Adrian, run Mum & Shirt Station, Caribbean street food. Been a chef for like over like 25 years, and then about 4 years ago decided to make my own business. We've got jerk chicken wings. We're doing like jerk chicken, rice and peas. We do a vegetarian sweet potato cake, and we do like a jerk fish cake as well. So we're trying to be a little bit different to your traditional Caribbean like takeaway.
Mix it up a bit
as well. We've got lovely fried plantain as well, and we also do like it's not a known thing, but we do like a jerk soup.
Okay.
Which is like a sweet potato based soup, and we put like jerk chicken in there and kidney beans and dumplings and stuff like that. Very wholesome.
Well, we are very lucky to have Adrian in the studio with us today. Hello, Adrian.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm really good. I'm really excited about this. How are you?
I'm excellent. Looking forward to this.
So, Adrian, what are you going to be showing us here today?
I'm basically going to show you how to make a jerk chicken wrap. Literally,
oh, wow.
We're going to get a little bit of salad in a wrap.
Yeah.
Right.
Let's do it quickly.
Oh, gosh.
I'm going to get some jerk chicken.
This is happening really fast.
Got a lovely sauce on there.
Oh, jerk chicken. Get that chicken, girl.
Right, simmer down, right?
Then we've got some lovely tropical mayonnaise. Some lovely hot pepper sauce. And then we're just going to wrap it up. There you go.
That's for me, thanks.
For you.
Wow, that's
can you do that quick?
I'll have a go at that.
What's in the special sauce?
It's a secret recipe, I can't tell you, but it's lovely.
The aroma from it is lovely, by the way. How many wraps can you do in a minute?
Probably about four or five.
Four or five?
Yeah.
Wow, that's pretty.
I can't do anything in a minute. So the fact that you can do four, are you the fastest?
I'm not the fastest, I've got guys who can do faster than me.
Faster than you.
Faster than
it's a bit like that.
So, what advice would you give to anyone who wants to take food on as a career, like as an entrepreneur?
I would say come up with a really good concept, do a bit of market research, go and see what other people are doing, see what you can do differently.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to ask questions.
That's
and
right.
Get advice, and then just take the plunge and go and do it.
That's awesome. And you see, just to pick up on that as well, what do you think what products attracts the customer?
I think anything that's being cooked visually, that creates a bit of like theatre.
It's
like food theatre. So when they actually see the food cooking and then being presented to them, and smells as well, that's the thing that attracts them.
That's right, the aroma alone just draws them in.
Yeah.
That's all that sweet sauce and pepper sauce and all of that.
Sweet.
Yeah. So some of you guys have tweeted in a challenge to us to do Asian, actually. The challenge is, wait for it. Thank you. Let's see what this challenge is saying.
I think I can guess what this challenge is going to be.
What's the challenge?
From the collection we have here. Yeah.
All right, then. This is from the Twitter guy, @Abby_301. Make as many wraps as you can in 30 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah. So you think you can handle that, Daisy?
I can burn a salad. So I don't know how well this is going to go, but we're going to try.
All right, let's have a go here.
It's about speed.
Who's going to go first?
You want to go first?
Yeah, no, I'll go first. Wait,
I'll just show you, yeah?
Speed
before beast.
You're going to get a wrap.
All right.
You're going to put it on there.
Okay, sweet.
You're going to get a little bit of salad.
Yep.
Yeah, and then you're going to get a bit of chicken on top.
Like, right, two pieces of chicken are we talking?
Two pieces.
Two's plenty,
fine. Two's fine. And then I'm going to show you how to wrap it up.
Okay, and I put these special,
Put these sauces on
there. Okay, sweet. Okay, right.
Okay.
Okay. So. Okay. Bring it on. Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
A bit of salad in there. Two bits of chicken.
I'm actually getting really panicky about this, but this is going to be fine. It's going to be fine.
A couple of bits of chicken. Sauce.
Okay. I've never been one for speed.
That's fine. And then the best way to wrap it is you hold it.
Okay.
Hold it like that.
Hold like that. And then just roll it.
Roll it.
Like a baby.
Yeah, just like that.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
There you go.
Can I pretend that's mine?
Pretend it's yours.
Okay, sweet. So I already have one. Sucker. Okay, right.
Let me just, hang on. Got to stop watching.
Okay.
You ready?
Okay. Okay, with the lettuce, and then putting that thing. Pretty sure this cucumber.
That's pretty quick.
And then I get two pieces of chicken. Come here, chicken! Okay, we're doing
seconds.
Both hands.
Ah! Oh,
big spill.
Oh, this is so
20
stressful.
Seconds. Can you finish it?
Yeah, no, I can. Hang on. Bear with me. Rolly McRoll. Oh, a little bit.
Done. 30 seconds done. Let's have a look at that.
I think that's a work of art.
Okay. Well done.
That's all you can really say. Well done.
Well done.
Wow, that was wow. Awesome. You did pretty well there.
One for you. Let me get a wrap for you.
I think I'm impressed with that. I don't know if you are, but I'm gonna take
a photo.
I'm reasonably
impressed.
Send that to my mum.
Did you see how we did it?
Yeah, I saw how she did it. Okay. I'm gonna show you how a real chef's in the kitchen. All take right. Notes, Adrian. Take notes.
Right, let's go. Go.
Okay, first one.
Bit of salad. Too much lettuce. Too much salad.
Too much lettuce.
Oh my gosh.
A couple of bits of chicken. Putting you off.
This is cheating, but I'm still a winner.
Spill it.
20 seconds. Let's get that wrap on.
What, you got two wraps there?
I've got two wraps there. Whoa.
I'm greedy. Adrian, talk to me. Adrian. Talk to me.
Let's have a look.
Have a look at that bad girl. That presentation is key.
I would say the winner is Daisy.
Yeah!
Oh!
The
winner
is Daisy. No, this is the first thing I've ever won. You're going to get your Olympic medal after. Well, Adrian, it's been a pleasure,
to be here
today with you. I'd just like to say a big thank you. And didn't we have so much fun, Daisy?
Literally, that was the best time ever.
Yeah, it was.
But yours is dying, okay? And I want to say thank you very much to you guys as well for this challenge. It was actually really great. Cheers, thanks.
Have a good
Oh, that was brutal. Now we're lucky to be joined in the studio by a member of a roller derby team, Charlotte. Woo! She's skating it. Hey! Hey, Charlotte. Okay, so give us an idea of the rules of playing roller derby.
The rules are basically there's five people on a team.
Yeah.
And you have one jammer on each team, and then the four are blockers. The jammer on each team has to race around the track. It's basically a flat track, like a racing track. And then the four blockers have to hit the jammer on the opposite team and stop them getting past them.
Oh my gosh, that sounds really, really fun. Yeah. It seems pretty violent though. So how much contact is actually allowed?
The contact that's allowed, you're not allowed to flare your arms around.
Yeah.
The contact is from basically in front of the bra line.
Yeah.
And with the shoulder or with the hip, but also again with sort of a straight line down the body. So you can't. Oh. You can't sort of hit someone in the front.
Oh,
you have to hit them there as well.
I was giving a little go, you know. So there's no hair. There's no hair pulling in it either.
No hair pulling, no nails. Just using the body.
Using the body, jiggling.
Yeah.
Anyway, so do you have any special maneuvers in there that you guys picked up?
It's not as fancy as it maybe sounds.
Yeah.
But you have to be able to just be really nimble on your feet, basically. And you can start on your toe stops, which it gives you sort of a running start as if you are going to run. And then you also sort of, you're able to turn around and then get back on your toe stops so that you can go in the other direction if you have to,
get knocked off. The toe stop looks a bit like ballet, like you were in a black swan there.
Yeah, you have to get some balance.
Can you show me some tricks, any little tricks you want to show?
I don't know. I mean, where am I allowed to go?
You can just go around here and do a little bedazzle.
I mean, wow. You sort of turn around. It's not that impressive. You basically learn how to fall and hit people. So the most fancy thing I could do is probably hit you. So.
Oh, no hitting today. We'll keep it real. Well, Charlotte, I'd say a big thank you, Charlotte, for coming in today.
No problem.
And now we're going to go over to Daisy with the latest updates on the hottest fashion.
Cheers, baby G. I love how, like, you said that the best thing you learn is, like, falling. Like, I love how you learn to fall. That's great. Okay, anyway, so. It's true, we received many tweets about urban fashion that we just had to talk about. So we went to Brick Lane earlier to find out just what's on trend.
We asked people what urban outfits they were wearing.
Scarf, North Face jacket, Chanel bag, $3 flea market.
My jacket's from Urban Outfitters. I'm wearing dots. I got this skirt at a vintage outlet.
Well, the dress is vintage. It's a mod Scudo skirt. Okay. I tend to mostly wear sort of vintage and secondhand stuff. I quite like 60s style.
We also found out what inspired their urban outfits.
My role model is Arvida Bystrom. She's a Swedish photographer.
We wake up in the morning, we think, what would Kanye do?
So in studio with us is Grace, who is our local fashion expert. Welcome to the show, Grace. Hello.
Hi.
You all right?
Yes, thank you.
Looking very fashionable, may I say.
Thank you very much.
I'm wearing my dad's little shirt here, so not that fashionable. So what have you got in store for us today, then, Grace?
Today I'm here to show you the collection from the Rated Company. If I'd like to bring on my models, if that's all right. So first up, we have Gifty. Gift is wearing the Rated Company white beanie. This is really perfect for the winter at this time of year. Styled with this white t-shirt with the gold company logo, which is different and unique look, and has the zips on the side that show this real urban design, which you can wear open or closed. This t-shirt goes really nicely with just some simple leggings for a real casual look. Thank you, Gifty. Up next we have Andre with this statement look. He is wearing the metallic cam cap, which is a five panel hat. Here with the Rated Company's Mary pullover look at this Virgin Mary design on the vintage hoodie. Perfect for the winter street edge. You can wear jeans with some classic vintage sneakers. Thank you, Andre. And last we have Ludo, who is wearing the signature coat jacket. One of my favourite pieces from the collection. And what I like about this jacket is the inside, as you can see, it has the edgy urban print, which is appropriate for this weather. Underneath the jacket, she is wearing a black mesh jersey. It's so edgy and it pairs perfectly with a timeless pair of denim shorts. Thank you, Luna.
Wow. All right then. What? It makes me feel kind of rubbish because they look amazing.
Very good.
You know, you're lucky if I brush my hair in the morning. So thanks a lot for coming in, Grace. That was really amazing. And if you guys want to find any of the clothes that you just saw, have a look on theratedcompany.co.uk.
Wow. The modelling section was good. Some of the swag that I saw was really great. I will take that jumper and wear it myself. You know.
So we'd like to thank all of our guest performers, models, and of course you guys for tweeting in and making the show possible.
That's right, guys. Thank you for watching and be sure to keep on tweeting us as we'll be back next week with a whole new lineup, which you decide by you guys at home. Decided.
And now we're going to end on a very special request from one of your viewers at Kez_World, who wants us to do a cypher in the studio.
Cypher? I wish we could do that. Well, we can't do one, but we know some people who can. We hope you guys have enjoyed the show. Sorry. See you next week.
See you later.
Cypher, Rex, Pyro, KDN. Know what time it is? It's about that time. It's time to go in. Listen, yo. Alright, what am I saying? Yo. Alright. Listen, yo. Never slacking, got that work up in my jeans. Ain't it ironic that my dogs be getting cheese? Cause they be in the trap, shoving food to them cats. We bust gas if they find out that you're a rat. Welcome to the hood, where the streets are like a rack. Where you either gang banging or you ripping in the trap. Product of your environment ain't blaming you for that. No silver spoons, cause you'll start from scratch. Enough of all the facts, let me spit something greasy. Coke bars, my lines stand out, no graffiti. Please believe me, you can get the sack. If you're in Man City, trying to ball Mancini. Listen, I was made for this. It's that time, so you know I gotta take the risk. Rather shooting for that money, call that baby clips. I stay sick, not a toilet, but I take the piss. Yeah. Listen. I got rap bars, but know that I'm a grime kid. And I'll ride on any beat as long as I like it. But don't you hate the tight witch, act like they have a nice chick. But just because you're light skin, it doesn't mean you're nice bitch. And yeah, the flow's nice, put the tight to bop your head to. And I go hard, like the guy your wifey is giving her to. Some niggas wanna stare, but I ain't stairs that you can step to. Cause what you're witnessing is fucking hard, like red tube. And I'm a predator on the mic, so don't be getting me in a hype. With flows, I'll be 7 minutes slicing when I ride a beat. And yeah, the roads are aggressive in the night. You better mind your speech or you might get peppered on the spice. Then like a slice of meat, I didn't wanna move peppers on the white and the strip. I for fiends, I'm trying to get my lines in the disc, so they supply for me. So writing up a track or firing at this lad ain't the brightest, fam. Don't front or leave you lying on your back. Ed Hardy, you ain't getting past me. Card, you ain't a breezer like Bacardi. I'll be screaming for my army. And without Twitter, I wouldn't follow another. If I'm on the come up, I guarantee they'll be between my ass cheeks and large. I ain't fake at all, I spit it real. And anorexic's what I've never been, but I'm missing meals. I'm hungry like poverty stricken kids with no giving skills. So I'll take the belly if I see it like hospitals will.
Yeah, we said KD. Yo, cause the vibe I'm on got me on this side, don't mind to die alone. Somebody drive me home, I just arrived. Already highest crows in the clouds with no spouse. Just a bottle of stout or Despies or Henny. Fuck it, I'll drink any. Gal them, yeah, I got plenty. Man them, yeah, they resent me. Fuck them though, I got 10 flows. They take rosés old. Moving up, cruising blood, no whip yet, but we choosing our way in the game to take your fame with your chick, babe. Say my name, KD. King and you know it, middle finger still showing to the ones that didn't listen, now you wanna witness. My presence got you all excited, but this isn't Christmas. But you still get wrapped if you get in my business. Somebody told Shabin, get the green and the pretty face team to let me in between. Jeez. And we can't be stopped like dodgy cops. So get me some guap, I don't holler at me, done.